Hello everyone, welcome back to Andromeda, where we last left off. We managed to get underground, turn on the atmospheric changers, or press services, or whatever. And now we're about to start a settlement, I think. So, let's do that, shall we?
This is where we'll build our new outpost. A real beginning.
Prepping deployment order. You must choose what purpose this new outpost will serve.
Okay.
The Nexus doesn't get a say?
Resources are at a crisis point. Protocol states this judgment call falls to the Pathfinder. With current supplies, you could build a military outpost, focusing on defense and militia training. Alternatively, a scientific outpost could advance the initiative's research and discoveries.
I'm choosing this outpost direction for decades, maybe centuries.
That is the prime responsibility of a Pathfinder. Be advised that the first outpost placed by a Pathfinder will be a statement in itself. Fair or not, your choice will represent the initiative and its intentions in Andromeda. Consider carefully.
Military or scientific? I'm sure there'll be a secondary outpost on here. For now, we need to get more science up so we can actually start making things. It's good to defend things, but we've got quite a lot of military personnel already up on top. Half of them ended up going somewhere else. But we still got enough. We don't have enough science people to go around and be like, hey, I know how to make this rock work so we can make food from fire without burning.
Prioritize research and discovery. That's our foundation. And our future.
Orders prepped. Ready on your signal.
Alright. Foothold.
Andromeda Initiative. This is Ryder. Pathfinder.
EOS is ready for deployment.
Copy that. Outpost block inbound and ready as hell.
Whee!
August Bradley, operational head for this block. Mayor now, I suppose. We're ready to make the most of what you delivered.
I feel like I should toss you the keys. Be nice. It's been through a lot.
Understood. Brodromos. That's what we're calling her.
That's what it said on the thing.
They're eager. I haven't seen eager for months. EOS is far from golden.
They set those things bloody
but
fast.
But now it's a producer. A real and reasonable first step. They think you did the impossible. The Nexus. I warned them. Hoping was irresponsible. You proved me wrong, Pathfinder.
I appreciate your candor. We're all on the same side.
I wouldn't go that far. The reality, Ryder? You brought us time. But one outpost on a long-shot planet won't stop us from starving.
Yes, I know.
You already have a lead on something else?
The nav point. From the vault.
Now it gets complicated. The others are ready to officially sanction your efforts, to be a part of your success.
Good.
We all want the initiative to succeed. But after failing for so long, no one agrees on how to do it. Be aware. That's all.
We didn't come to a new galaxy to argue about who's right.
It got us this far. Talk to Bradley. Later, we'll go over the extended job of Pathfinder. Until then. Tan's waiting on the Nexus.
Is your patch glitching into your arm? I still don't like you. No, it's at 78%. And I'm all the way up here. And my car's all the way down there. Why? Speak with Addison on the Nexus. Find Anna Carell's final research. Well, there's traffic coming in. Lots and lots
radiation
of traffic.
Radiation levels increasing.
But why? I mean, I'm inside. Why would it increase? Hello? Your name is Yale? What's up?
I'm sorry it came to this, Pathfinder.
What? Came to what? And then he whips out a gun and tries to shoot me! Little did he know I was an expert in combat, and killed him in 3 shots. One to the knee, one to the other knee, and one to the leg. Well, to the head, I mean. Unless I want to shoot him in the leg again. Not only did I shoot him in the knee, I shot him in the leg, too. Because the Nomad's already here. Why would I call it if it's already here? Hello? Hey, Connor, heard about the new position. Prodromus just gained one hell of a businesswoman. They're lucky to have you. If we ever find ourselves on the Nexus at the same time, I'm buying you a drink to celebrate. Vetra. And Ryder, I know you're going to get nosy and read this. Hi. Oh. Hi.
Everyone thinks that at first. The doctors have a name for it by now. It just needs time.
Who are you talking to? There's no one here. Hello,
Pathfinder.
Jacob Mitney.
A word with you?
What's up?
Pathfinder. Jacob Mitney, Research and Development. My team's just getting set up here, but we've made a discovery you might want to check out.
Uh-huh.
All ears.
We've put together a blueprint for augmenting your armor plating. Uploading it now. If you can collect the necessary resources from around Eos, it should work.
Should work.
Is this a sure thing, Mitney, or just pie in the sky?
I have no interest in wasting your time. This could form the basis for armor production across the initiative. Scrounge safely, Pathfinder.
All right. No messages on here. Craft the Pathfinder chess piece. Hello? Oh, suddenly all these people.
Solid ground. An actual sunlight to wake up to. This will be great.
I don't know about that.
Enjoy it. I'll be up all night collecting moisture readings.
Are you sleeping better?
Yeah. Doc says it's just post-stasis anxiety.
PTSA? Hello?
Hello. Hello, Kim Connor. Supplies, trade, procurement. Anything you need, I can provide.
Cool.
Though you do have the Queen Quartermaster beside you.
You know Vetra?
But I need ground under my feet, and soon, hopefully, trade will flourish on Eos.
Trade partners.
Is Eos trading with any new partners?
Right now, just the Nexus, but I have contracts with Wildcat Salvages and independent miners. There will be more.
Does the outpost have everything it needs?
The Nexus furnished us with the basics, but that isn't enough for a home. Providing the rest is my responsibility.
Oh, well,
the labs can't work without good logistics. They'll have it.
You said you know Vetra. What's she really like?
As you like. Of course, you can't always be listening.
So how did you end up here, Connor?
Me? You're the Grand Explorer. I fill out requisition forms.
Really? Everyone here has some kind of story.
I left mine back home. Or... the... still... ask me another time.
What?
See you later.
Be well. Come back again.
You said I could buy stuff from you, but I didn't get anything from you.
Helps that there's zero pollution here, but yeah, it tastes new.
Yeah. New air.
Ryder.
Sup.
Henderson at the shuttle landing pad told me. He heard a pilot.
Izzy, you've got to stop listening to him.
Making the request again, Bradley. I know it's not your fault. I know you're supposed to be second way, but I want a trail so that all this calms down a few years. We can get proper outraged about how long it took to reunite families, especially ones hurt during the Site 1-2 mess. You know broken promise is a thing, right? Requesting the deployment of Darket Tiervan, W84 Crispin, Exo-Study Specialist. Reason, she's an asset that will help viability. She's also my daughter. Okay. Merchant! Okay, Cobra. Carnifex 2, Pathfinder Helmet 2. I don't mind making this, I guess. I don't have enough though, so I can't even if I wanted to. Oh yeah, I was going to sell you my full salvage. Confirm trade. Whoa, I have a lot of money now. Sure, I'll buy this. I'll buy... Do you have... Boost life support capacity and allows the user to survive hazardous environments longer outside the Nomad. Huh. Sure, I'll buy one of those. Buy some shield capacitors. And I guess I'll buy the Carnifex. Explosive projectile launched from an Oni tool that deals massive damage. Sure, why not? And I'm done.
Really hope all those scientists will be safe out here. We came to explore and learn. That's who we are.
Already getting requests from the Prodromos labs.
We need more fuel and need to construct additional pylons. Kane Forks.
Hi. You haven't got a fuel cell, have you? The quartermaster says there's plenty, but she would. Wait. Oh, shit, you're the Pathfinder. Sorry, no one said VIPs were coming by.
I'm just Ryder. Nice to meet you.
It's a pleasure to meet you, too. I'm Fox, Chief Engineer at your service.
What's the job?
What do you do here?
My team gets things going. Water, power, communications, everything a civilization needs. Well, not laws or a constitution, but it's easier to concentrate on those when you got a flushing toilet.
Alright.
What brought you all the way to Andromeda?
There's a colony back home you've never heard of. Viridus. It failed. Hard. I grew up there watching things fall apart. When I left, I got into infrastructure, civil engineering. Boring stuff unless you've ever lived without it. I wanted to do Viridus right, I guess. And the initiative was my best chance.
Alright.
Thanks for asking.
What do you think about your new home?
First impressions? We've got water, clear skies for solar power, plants to farm. The Remnant are a wild card, but I hear you almost have that solved, which is amazing. And you found us a good site here. I think Eos is really going to be special.
We'll see.
What are the other outpost staff like?
Like Connor, you mean? She's pretty fun when you get to know her. Just don't get to know her over a poker game. Trust me.
Okay.
Bye, Fox.
Bye. Stay safe out there.
Bye. Gah, 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 gah. Anyway. scratch pad, login chief and cane forks, files, sketches, annotations and exploded schematic views, many are focused on a combined road monorail network for EOS, showing several different but brilliant designs. Go back to old standby when you need to think about. Underneath are several dudes showing elegant redesigns of the Nexus tram system map. Posted to one side are a number of downloaded schematics or statistics on predicted population growth over the next century. Got a baseline. Bradley's always good for the numbers. Adjoining the statistics is a blocked out simplistic drawing of Prodromos. Dotted line showing expansion with detailed sketches of water and sewage lines underground. Wireless power routers and the flow of foot traffic. Sloppy, but it's a start. Aside is a sketch of Pathfinder helmet with downloaded notes on material testing and safety regulations. Design fundamentals look sound. No need to worry. Okay. Out we go. Right, we check that building. Let's go over this way then, I guess.
Pathfinder.
What's up? Soil. There's a thing! I will grab the thing!
Sam, another memory trigger?
Yes, though my memory array remains locked. Additional triggers are required.
Fine, I've got to be triggered more.
Mayor Bradley.
Pathfinder, good to see you. We're busy as anything, thanks to you. Bit dusty, but we can adapt. It's worth it when it's your own.
Let's not drive people too hard. Rough enough getting this far.
Nothing you see here came from cracking a whip. Everyone is just ready. You go do what you need to on the Nexus. Follow that dot. There will be more to do on EOS later. Some key positions: Connor Supply, Ramirez Medical, Abrams Science, Fawkes Engineering. With them and my major domo, we won't end up like Site 1 and 2.
I combed the first two outpost attempts. Those people died trying.
And they deserved better from the Nexus. That's where I point the finger. We'll remember. You changed this planet. But that doesn't make it easy. We'll use the efforts of those who went before. Good people, every last one. I'd have been honored to fail with any of them.
I haven't reached the end of that trail, but not everyone died outright.
Right. They tell me there were staggered evacs. If any want to try again, they're welcome. Oh, and Pathfinder, this is for you. It's our flag. Hang it where the Nexus can see. It's touched the soil of our first outpost in Andromeda. Make it real.
Okay.
Head for the Nexus, Pathfinder. Prodromos will have more going on when you come back later.
All right. I still want to have a look around, and I still have a few quests here, so I'm not going to leave just yet.
Hello there.
Hi.
Ah, Pathfinder. I hear you're to thank for a physics-defying atmosphere processor.
That's me. I'm Ryder.
Hanley Abrams, Director of Scientific Research on EOS, and writer of papers that start What the Hell Weather. But new galaxy, new world, and a really new start. Gotta keep up. How can I help you?
What's up?
What do you make of Lieutenant Bradley?
Determined as hell. And he has incredible faith in us to get this done. Bradley would carry this outpost on his back if he had to, and we'll make sure he never has to.
What kind of research are you working on?
Your basic first in scientific work. Soil, water, atmospherics. Plus studying remnant tech, because now I need to understand that to survive here.
True.
Activating that vault changed the planet. Anything to worry about?
Considering it's world-altering technology we've never encountered before, I hope not. But the storms show no signs of returning, and I know who to contact for remnant tech support. I'll take it.
That's me.
What brought you out here to Andromeda?
Back home, I was filling test tubes in some dead-end lab. People knew me as Stefan, but that was never who I was. I knew what I could do, and I knew who I wanted to do it as. Hanley Abrams, Andromeda Explorer. That's me. Feels good. Feels right.
Why Hanley?
What made you choose the name Hanley?
It's the initials of all my favorite places back home. My fiancé helped me pick it before we left. When it's time, I'm hoping Bradley will perform our wedding ceremony.
Oh.
I've gotta go.
Keep up the good work.
Yeah, I know I'm doing. I can turn things on. Junseo Park.
Pathfinder? Mind giving me your opinion on this? I'm planning classes for our first school, when we have one. Some say we shouldn't teach Milky Way history. All irrelevant now, apparently.
No, it still matters.
We were all shaped by that history. Our children deserve to know how and why.
Agreed. Maybe you'll change a few minds. Thanks for stopping.
Oh, we came from the Milky Way. Let's forget everything we learned from there so we can do the same mistakes again. And the same progresses we lose because we don't know how the hell they did it in the past. How? What technology can do this quickly? Neutralizing the radiation in the atmosphere without dramatic storm effects? Shit, the opposite. The weather's gone calm as a summer's day. That unprecedented control over atmospheric pressure, gas mixture, temperature, what else? And where's the interaction? Pause break. Mr. Dogs, walking them in the shuttle park always helped me think through these problems. Forget side effects too. I should get a dog. Where are the dogs? We got damn lucky with the conditions here. They're as comparable to sea level Earth. Eos is dry but within limits. Moisture is binding into the desert and plants and soil more now since the vault points to a species with the same air mixture, temperature, gravitational support, comfort levels as us. Or is there another reason? Can't predict intent for the results. Maybe Ryder's the one to figure out why. The how? That's my department now. Lucky old Hanley, you wanted bigger things, you got sure got them now. Yep, that's what I do. I find out the why, and sometimes even the how. To be fair, that's pretty much me in any game. Bell Scott.
Pathfinder. Majordomo Evan Bell Scott. I have headaches, so you don't have to. Rather, so Bradley doesn't have to. I've also coordinated with your KET expert. He wanted me to remind you to find him.
I didn't assign a KET expert to Podromos.
Then he's a hell of a self-motivator. Here's the nav, anyway. Precision is important.
Okay.
Thoughts on how the outpost is doing? The planet?
Stellar. We keep it up. We'll make this world look like the brochures.
Cool.
How did you come to the initiative?
Like many, I was lost and looking for a purpose. That sounds loftier than it felt at the time. I was an insufferable ass.
Where are you going?
The training for the trip was probably enough to cure me of it. But I always took things too far. Didn't know how to stop alienating people until I was the alien. See? Still insufferable.
Where do you launch out of?
The pale blue dot, Terra Prime. Big old boring Earth. I miss that wet dog smell after the first snow melts. I don't know why.
Uh-huh.
What about you? Miss anything?
I miss the time on the couch before media loads. Make your choice, and as a B-minus rom-com bounces between satellites, the size of the planet decides how long you wait in the dark.
Your popcorn sounds nice, Pathfinder.
Sounds like you left some interesting circumstances.
I miss the family, and maybe they miss me. But that doesn't mean I'd go back. I mean, we can't, but still. I like where I came from. It's a great place to be from. You know what I mean?
Bastard.
I don't know. I liked where I was. There were other things that brought us here.
Not me. Eyes on distant stars. Always have been.
Another time.
Of course.
I mean, there were other things to talk about, but for some reason he got stuck
what
on that one.
What do you need, Pathfinder?
That one choice.
Thoughts on your boss?
The old man. He's pretty tied into what happens here. I just pick up the day-to-day scraps. Good at cracking the whip for these science types. Doesn't fall for the details. I hope he's proud. Feels like he's proud.
Any trouble with the cat?
Clearing the sky cleared it for the bad guys as well as us. So, some uptick in hostility was to be expected. We've some tricks up our sleeves, thanks to the research teams. That only goes so far. Your expert is still out there. He'd have more current information than I.
Yeah, I didn't send anyone about an expert.
Another time.
Of course.
Unless Drac counts himself as one and somehow just done that. To Director Tan from A. Bradley. Tan, appreciate the personal interest, but my people are getting it twitchy with all the messages you're sending them. I'd like their minds on the job, not being under a microscope. Addison's the one I call. I get it, Site 1 and 2 are still raw for us too, but Prodromos isn't the same. No better way to prove that than to let us do our jobs. Give them space and I'll give you all the footage you need to make it play well back on the Nexus. Agreed, Bradley. Alright. So, Tan sounds like one of the ones that are just like, they're the, how are they called, the micromanagers. Addison sounds like the one that just is a dick to everyone.
Bradley really should.
The Krogan woman sounds like she's just the one that's trying to help people. And the Turian's the same. About.
Ryder, yes?
Yes.
Dr. Ramirez, run the clinic here on Eos. Much better than life as an Alliance medic.
Good to meet you.
I'll guess you're not here for a checkup. How can I help you?
Your clinic.
What's the latest from your clinic?
Usual checkups for first-in colonists. Plus a few cases of dehydration and sun blindness. Nothing serious.
Sun blindness?
What do you think of Bradley?
I've known him for years. He was the squad medic when he was injured, and we kept in touch after his discharge. He's a smart fellow, a good lieutenant, but a better mayor. And it bugs him when I call him August. So I restrict myself to 2-3 times a day.
What's it like living in our first successful outpost?
It's early days, but promising. Everyone pitches in, everyone matters. We know we'll make this work.
Nice.
Why did you join the Andromeda Initiative?
I was bored.
I served in the Alliance as a medic, but they'd say I saw one Batarian slave raid too many. I knew August, Bradley, and when he signed on to the Initiative, he suggested I consider it. This seemed like a better frontier.
All right.
I'll leave you to it.
Come back anytime. Preferably unhurt.
You never know. I might end up getting shot with a shotgun. I don't know. Victor Carson. Mr. Joseph, find it trouble that you think I could be swayed from duty by an offer of credits. I understand Victor Carson is a friend of yours, but that's hardly an adequate reason to release him from cryostasis and send him the Prodromos. Beyond that, from what I hear, you two are a disaster waiting to happen. I know all about the prank you and Mr. Carson pulled on Everett before the journey to Helios. Victor Carson will be released on stasis when I see fit. He's assigned to an outpost that best suits his skill set, and if I hear you've gone over my head and spoken to Anderson about this, you'll have me to answer you. Administrator Brecker. Dr. Ramirez. Symptoms: acute insomnia, claustrophobia. Apparently suffered a mechanical failure when coming out of stasis that locked her in the pods. Clearly a psychosomatic case, but symptoms are acute. Related conditions, the techies solved a lot of the physical effects of long-term stasis, but we've clearly seen the psychological effects run a lot deeper. People are just aren't designed to be turned off for too long. Let's talk with Haley about the research, about long-term research initiative. We're thirst for a lot of things. Patient lost his grip and fell during maintenance. Multiple leg fractures. Jump jets failed to fire. Compound fractures to the right leg. Severe sprains to the left ankle. Patient followed showed an allergic reaction to anesthetics, so I borrowed August and a couple of engineers to hold 076 down while I set the legs. Application of foam cast and appropriate analgesia followed. Noisy day, but hopefully an object listened to the rest of the outpost about jump jet maintenance. Patient is healing nicely. Should be falling off roofs again in a week. Cool. They don't have proper beds yet. They're sitting on, like, little mattresses on the floor. I took back the last one, and I can't even get inside, so that's fine. I hear talking over there, but there's no one over there. Go check that out, then we'll head to the Nomad and head off on the quest. So this looks like some sort of bridge, or like, thing. Quarantine. Best practices. Please remember that everything shipped to the landing pad, especially from off-world, rather than sealed Nexus supplies, must go through quarantine procedures via confined observation, spot testing, bacteriological scans, or radioactive sterilization. We are new presence on EOS, and everything they did to this ecosystem will have an effect down on the line. Our job is to make sure it's a beneficial one, and a strong quarantine practices will really help us out. Haley Abrams. Addendum. If anyone tries to tell me or Haley that your shipments are a special case and you don't need to bother, you'll be running quarantine twice. The Vault Doohickey might be clearing the atmosphere, but we still got pockets of high radiation and bad weather across the continent. Telepresence update. Zeros 10 and 12 are still smoking hot, but Zone 8 is showing a drop. Watch your shuttle radiation shield absorption. They can take up to 190 MSV per hour safely. Anything more and you need to head back to for a refit. And remember that if you're carrying power cells or radiological equipment, those can be throw your readings off. Make sure you are safe as you think. Monitoring sweep, sign up early or you'll lose your equipment slots. Retrieving Sigma plus plant specimens, high altitude, atmospheric obs with time slot astronomical duty. Nothing from you two. An item. And then there's some buildings over here. Okay, then I guess we'll quickly check these and then we'll go out. Probably won't be too much longer. This is the restart station. Please help. The only way I can get word out before someone gets killed. My crew, they keep talking about the remnant tech. They think the initiative's lying about how dangerous it is, that a couple of electrodes in the right place could get the remnant tech to work for them instead. They tried before and I helped out in Medbay when those remnant observers card Barty. But Jennings says we could live like kings if we had an army of remnant bots working and fighting for us. He's taking the whole work crew to help with this time. I have to go with them. Maybe I can talk Jennings out of it. But if I can't, someone should know why we didn't come back.
Someone left a warning. Looks like a work crew thinks they can take control of the remnant. That's an incredibly bad idea.
Work crew rosters are posted publicly.
The datapad mentioned Medbay. A little work, we could find where to catch up with them.
Can I not use this? This looks like this the research bay. Well, alright then. We'll just check this last one and then we'll head off to the med bay in the next episode. I don't think there's anything in here much though. Let me try again. I don't think there's much in here though. Oh, this is the research center. Okay. And armor. How do these? Alright. Augmentations. Aerial lubricant, aerial performance, stabilizers, equilibrium. I wonder if there's one for... Seeker grenade, electrical conduits. No, there isn't one. I was hoping to find one for... atmosphere stuff. There doesn't seem to be one. I guess it's fine. I guess I'll at least learn about this. Can't. 125 50 150 150 290. Beam emitter, cryostatic condenser, heat inducer, shield oscillator. Power boost. Cool. I guess I'll get one of these at least. Development. Ready to develop. So this is showing what I can actually build, I guess. Any armor? I can build this, but I'll just check to see if there's anything else I can build. Not really. Ultra rare blueprint. Power damage to armor, power bonus damage to armor. Okay. All combo, tech recharge, and I guess I'll do that. There we go. Helmet. Initiative helmet 2. I can't really make any of these. Agility mode. Speedy assist, which is always on by default, to be disabled. Great control of the vehicle with stability assist disabled. The Nomad is more agile, but will have less traction when cornering. Defensive or emergency shield discharge. I want to go with defensive organ. There we go. All good. And with that, we're going to stop here. In the next episode, we're going to go check out the med bay for the information we need to find, and then go from there. So thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoyed, and I shall see you next time, guys. Until then, bye-bye.